Ben, if there's any reassurance I can offer?
After all you've done for me, you should know that I got your back. I just don't relish the idea of something happening to you before I get a chance to repay you.
I would never expect anything in return between friends. And, about the whole clone thing?
It's all good, Adam. Relax. Yeah, I was surprised, but I had a good think about it. It doesn't change my view of you in any way. I've already got Eduardo up and running again, Cal is happy, and Delia has a good handle on base management at this stage.
That's all very encouraging to hear.
To risk your particles being rearranged for this alien technology?
You're just sore you didn't come up with it yourself.
I have other priorities, in case you fail to notice. Keeping you alive, for one.
And that's rewarding enough for you. Kala, are you there?
Nama? Yes, Cleco, I am here.
I'm at the first location. So what happens now?
Use the cube with the right components to create a rip in space.
Rip in space, yeah, so you keep saying. Okay, so I need all these components? Some seem very particular.
I'll give you a list of the appropriate components. They are a little different here than in my homeworld, but they should serve their purpose.
I see, okay. I'll call you again once I have the basics. Alright, seems like I need all the parts to make this work. Let's see what we got. I did it! It's done! Kala, are you there? I established the first spatial bypass, the first rip!
Yes, Cleco. I've seen the energy surge near you. You can use any rip to get back here.
So I should be able to fast travel between here and the home base now. I need to establish more points if I want to get around quickly.
Yes, Clico, you can build more. I'll give you a few more places that fit. It doesn't work everywhere.
Got it. Let's try this out now, shall we?
No. You risk being translocated to your grave.
It was a hypothetical question, Hive. I really don't need your opinion.
This technology goes against all science. I thoroughly disapprove of it. Appearances, yes. Although we shouldn't discount the possibility that we have entered a parallel universe.
With a similarly grouchy onboard AI? Nah, I doubt it, Hive. You're one of a kind.
All probabilities are equally probable. Plays havoc on my geolocationary sensors.
You'll get used to it, Hive. I take it this is the automated freighter we're plundering?
Actually, I'll be doing the footwork this time. You keep lookout.
Sure thing. Hey, what's your real name anyway?
Tick-tock. What is it to you?
Just making small talk. Not like anyone's gonna intercept us out here.
Codes to crack. Oh, scrap. I just set off the alarm.
You... what?
What did you expect? I'm boarding the freighter illegally, ain't I?
Several fighters incoming.
You chose the wrong cart.
Hi, Clockwork. I take it this is the automated freighter we're plundering?
Actually, I'll be doing the footwork this time. You keep lookout.
Sure thing. Hey, what's your real name anyway?
Tick-tock. What is it to you?
Just making small talk. Not like anyone's gonna intercept us out here.
Duck the freighter. Code's to crack. Oh, scrap. I just set off the alarm.
You... what?
What did you expect? I'm boarding the freighter illegally, ain't I?
Several fighters incoming.
You chose the wrong cargo, and now you will die.
I suppose I'll deal with these guys, yeah?
Me up for a while.
I'm really doubting we went through all this trouble, or those guys put up such a defense for banana mangoes.
Content should not concern you. You'll be paid for your services.
I still have questions.
Yeah, well, I hear the service bots on Prescott lend a good ear for the right price. See you around, cowboy.
Thank you. come on in, dear boy.
Actually, I was hoping to see Daryl this time. He has some answering to do.
Daryl is indisposed at the moment, but I can appreciate you need some kind of explanation for the missions he's been sending you on.
It got a bit hot out there. I can't believe I went through all that for fruit.
We've known each other a while now, Adam. You're like family to me, and we have cause for celebration.
Champlain? I don't get it.
A toast to Daryl and Clockwork.
What?
They've just tied the knot. Shouting and arguing the whole way through the ceremony, mind you, but the boy did good. They're adorable together, ain't they?
I knew there was something going on. The raid we did on the shipment.
I've been hard on Daryl. I've been trying to raise him right and help him find his own way. He needed a bit of a push. So, he had to find incentive to move on up in the business. I told him I'd only consent to him taking a wife if he paid the nuptials himself.
I doubt Fruit would have paid for much.
Nah, it was something bigger. Like you suspected, plushies.
I risked my life, 3 times, for plushies.
Hey, not just any plushies, highly valuable collectibles worth a fortune to hardcore space opera fans. Clockwork brought the shipment onto the station. They sold it. Daryl popped the question, and they got hitched in the casino chapel all within minutes. Oh, these youngsters move fast.
Makes my head spin imagining it.
That would be the Champlain.
Where they go on honeymoon?
Upstairs. They'll be back to work in a couple of hours. Anyway, to love.
To love, I guess.
Marianne will see you out. Don't forget to check in with her for jobs every now and then. Oh, wait, I have something for you. A wedding gift. I'm feeling generous. You'll find it outside.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
for a while.
There are more Okar incoming.
Is now connected with my steadily growing network of spatial bypass locations.
I would still rather the tried and tested means of trusted jump gate travel.
A very conservative viewpoint, Hive. Nothing changes without risk.
Tell me anything else about my other iterations?
It would be difficult to summarize and indiscreet in any case.
I mean, maybe I'm different from them in some sense?
I do find it interesting that you have acquired new acquaintances, which could be considered a level of social engagement, which was beyond most of your earlier self-centered iterations.
Okay.
What's with those tubes?
They contain dead anemones. The only remaining sample still alive is located over there. Scientist can tell you more about it.
Everything else here is either dead or long gone. I guess this wraps up our investigation.
to Stardust.
Hey, Adam, you need some assistance?
Sure, why not? Enjoyed that.
Ancients are approaching. Combat appears inevitable.
I wish I knew what they wanted. What's your take on the current situation?
Time is moving forward, and the universe built around it will eventually cease to exist, obliterating all meaning to the blip of our existence.
No, I mean, what's our current situation right now?
Yes, it helps to be specific. We are moving through space. What we do next ultimately does not matter.
Unbelievable.
And yet true. Containing the father, Bernard. I detect only one life sign.
What are they doing, Hive?
The vessel is being bombarded with an unknown dark energy. This, I presume, is how the cult gains a hold over their new initiates.
So this is how Redeemers are made, huh? Let's put a stop to this.
Some kind of predict. You got a problem?
Don't talk. Shoot.
I somehow doubt they will appreciate the lesson. The ritual, although I fear we may be too late. The father's life signs display a slowed metabolism and an indication of possibly compromised cerebral activity.
That vessel must be AI driven. Where's it heading, Hive?
It is returning to the Ryan jump gate.
Again? Maybe it's a default setting. Let's free this guy once and for all. I'm on your father's trail. The Redeemers have performed some kind of ritual on him.
Oh no! I hope we are not too late!
Is there anything else you can tell me about these jerks that might help me in any way?
They were once scientists themselves. Research Department for Extinct Extraterrestrial Monuments.
Okay, well, that might Might at least explain why their vocabulary range is better than that of the average outlaw.
Containing the father is already in the station hangar.
Let's try to get him out of there before this goes any further.
You insist on impending on our business. We will deal with you severely.
Finally, someone a little less insane. Let's try talk. Hand over the scientist Bernard, and we'll end this here, okay?
There is no one of that name. Only a fresh redeemer to continue the work of the ancients.
Well, so much for wishful thinking. There's no negotiating with these nutbags.
Appears to be of exceptional power.
Supercharged from whatever the Redeemers have been feeding it. Facing wardens is always tough work.
If you pick the fight, you must expect to finish it.
Are these old-timey sayings pre-programmed into you, Hive?
The warden will devour your soul.
So you keep implying. You should listen to yourself sometimes.
Stop! The warden must be spared!
Looks like the warden is being re-caged. How are they doing that?
We will surrender the convert you seek.
Finally, some reason from you all.
He is but one of many among our collective. He can be relinquished in order to ensure the continuation of our great work.
Okay, prepare to hand him over. Imogen, I've secured your father's release. Come through the jump gate for extraction.
I'm already nearby. I've been watching events from a safe distance.
I thought I told you to stay put. Listen up, you crazed loons. This lady is approaching your dock. Allow her to collect her father or expect consequences.
We will not interfere.
Go on in, Imogen.
I have him. He is unconscious. Oh, Papa, I know you can hear me. Stay with me. Eyes. Oh no.
Do you have anywhere to go?
I can bring him to his colleagues. They will find a way to help him. Among them are some of the best neurophysicists in the cluster.
Imogen, take your father there and never come back to this place. I fear they might have a hold on him that he may never escape.
There must be a way I can repay you.
No, there isn't. Just let me know later how it turned out.
I will be in touch. Thank you.
have entered an area that is rich in resources.
Thank you.
time. The faster a ship moves, the slower time passes, right?
That would be a crude summarization of time dilation while nearing light speed, yes.
So, in Superlight, if time is moving slower outside our frame of reference, how come we still receive radio message in real time?
The original Adam Roslin would have known such fundamental concepts of the Eterna Cloud System back end.
These space-time paradoxes can be disorienting. I just need it explained in layman's terms on occasion.
Layman astrophysics will not get you anywhere, quite literally. We have more pressing matters right now, so please focus on your current objective, pilot. I have detected a high amount of valuable resources in this area. A successful outcome to this engagement. Well done.
Crashed wreck. The vortex has certainly taken its toll.
I must inform you that this is not any crashed wreck, but the CEV Nordborg. Disguised as a colonial exploration vessel, it was used during the war to move experimental weaponry through the belt grades.
Experimental weaponry, huh?
Even in its current state, it appears to be protected by some kind of disruptive signal, and a very unusual one at that.
Unusual in what sense?
It is like nothing I have ever encountered.
Damn it, Hive, pull yourself together.
SOS. This is Commander speaking. The frequent jamming mice require a tow.
It's jamming my AI too. Do you know how to deactivate it? I need to get closer if I want to make any sense out of him.
Someone to pull me out. The noise is killing me.
What noise?
Ugh, it is splitting my skull.
Okay, hold on. I got you.
Thank you. Drop me off at the bow. There is a maintenance dock there. If there is just an iota of power left, I could get myself running again.
You sure? The ship is a wreck.
The repairing units are supposed to be autonomous, so there is a chance. Just get me away from the noise. I can barely think straight. It's broadcasting from the stern of the vessel. I would steer clear if I were you.
Is the signal still messing with you?
No, it is gone. I think I will be fine now.
Good, because this is all I can do for you. Good luck with patching yourself up. I'm out of here for now. Need to get my AI rebooted.
I just need some peace.
The signal is definitely protecting something. Maybe I should pay a visit to Fallon Pango. He might know how to protect Hive from that jammer.
May I inquire about where we are going?
Thanks, Sol, you're back.
A remarkably powerful jamming signal interfered with my systems.
Next time we're not going in unprepared. Fortunately, I might just know the right guy for this.
The way you are phrasing this leads me to expect the worst.
Escort. Oh, I guess I'm it, huh?
Hostiles have sent additional fighters.
I've been cloned so many times that my memory is fuzzy, but didn't there used to be more black holes in the DMZ?
Indeed. Such minor singularities are still present. They can wander or be manipulated to relocate.
So I'm just not bumping into them as much because...
They are a navigational hazard. Interstellar routes were updated to avoid them. Unless you particularly enjoy being spaghettified by massive gravitational events.
Ah, spaghetti. Now I'm hungry. To do anything for him?
Yes. In fact, that's why I'm calling. He's awake and full of new ideas. And he has made some kind of breakthrough about the Redeemers.
Okay. Interesting.
Look, do you think you could pay us a visit on Avonrest? My father would like to meet you himself, and we'd like to make a proposition.
Well, I am curious. I'll swing by when I can.
Thanks so much. I'll see you then.
I could still beat you.
Before taking it out.
keep it up?
Thank you.
I detect heightened outlaw activity circling these coordinates. It is likely that you will become involved in a raid should you choose to dock here.
You came. Let me introduce you to my father, Professor Bernard Lefrere.
Please, first names. Can't have such formalities with the man who saved my life. It is an honor to meet you, young man.
The pleasure is mine.
I am ever indebted to you for rescuing me from the clutches of those poor maniacs. You know, you bear the striking resemblance of a subject for dissection I once made. It must be my age, my memory playing with me.
Yeah, I get that a lot. So, you made a full recovery? How did you manage that?
My colleagues worked diligently to reverse the effects of the dark energy which bombarded my mind, and found a way to accelerate recovery by using subsonic wavelengths.
Interesting.
That's why we asked you here. We think we can do the same for the Redeemers. We can save them from their madness. But we would need your help.
Oh, well, I am approached for a lot of favors, you know.
Undoubtedly, because you are such a competent person. It speaks well for your character.
Okay, give it to me straight. What are you planning?
My father's team has developed a device which can funnel these dark energy blocking wavelengths and transmit them over short distances.
So to say, we have developed an infrasound burst missile which, if delivered within range of a Redeemer, can disrupt their link with the ancient curse which has them in their grip. We need someone brave enough to go back into their territory, confront them up close, and give them a therapeutic dose of this infrasound frequency.
They were all just normal people once. I suppose they deserve a second chance.
I told you he was a good man with a good heart, Father.
Does this mean you will assist us in this vital work?
That would seem the right thing to do.
Bravo! Your kindness in this matter is to be commended. Meet me near the Redeemer base, and we will begin our work.
What? You're coming too? This might be dangerous, Bernard.
I know the risk. I've seen the darkness. All the more reason I must be there to calibrate the device and bring salvation to those poor souls. I will meet you there.
Thanks, Adam.
Aren't you a little worried that your father is throwing himself back into jeopardy again?
No, because I know he has you at his side.
Hey, how did you find us?
I have almost 24 markers on my map. This was one of them.
Scrap. This is bad. Uma, the distractors are offline. We're sitting ducks here.
I'll fix them, but I might need someone to have my back in case those bastards show up.
I'm used to this kind of stuff. I can cover you.
All right. Set yourself up, then tag along. We don't have much time.
While you hold them off.
Got it.
Confirm your mining drill is operational. Affirmative, mining terminal. Mining drill is online and ready for operation.
First one's up. Follow me.
Thank you.
aggressive.
They've been trying to pin us down for a while. They won't wait for another chance.
Saved our derrieres out there. Pay him well, Tico. He deserved it.
Here, does this account for your trouble?
It's more than enough.
If there is anything else we can do, we gave your ship clearance to bypass the distractors. Feel free to come back anytime.
Your while to look for resources in this area.
urgent assistance. Again.
Executed.
Take care of this emitter. Wouldn't want innocents to get hurt. Here they come.
I've been thinking.
Wonders never cease. Please, do enlighten me.
I mean, if I've been cloned so many times, I must have all the knowledge of my every iteration in me somehow, right?
Up to the limitation that your current chronology of memory transfers allow, yes. But that is still a very limited scope.
I feel like there's more to unlock in there. Sometimes I'm not sure what's my real past and what's a dream.
Memory transfers are not a precise science. It might be a blessing that you do not recall each and every horrible deed your alternative selves have committed.
Resources here.
Bravo!
EMP general broadcast incoming.
Let me guess. Outlaws have gained strength in some regions?
Indeed.
More escalation is just what I need.
Thank you.
Adam, you've come. Of course, I'll do my bit when called. Your selflessness in this vital task is vastly appreciated by all. My colleagues on Avonrest will be observing remotely and have taken huge interest in the outcome of our undertakings.
Let's get this party started. I don't like to wait around this area too long.
I understand. Redeemers are likely to appear any moment. Here, I've dispatched the infrasound missile delivery system, called the Exorcist for short. Imogen's idea, not mine. Sweet child. Pick it up and install it on your craft without delay.
Got it. This isn't likely to mess up anything on my ship, I hope.
Not at all. It will only be used for this mission. It will not affect your ship's system in any way.
Thank you for asking. I have enough experimental tech to deal with as it is, without a new factor to consider.
And once we're ready, we must find a redeemer to, well, deprogram, for want of a better word.
Well, there's enough of them around.
When you shoot a target, it will be marked. Stick to that one target, as it will need to be bombarded several times in order for this to work. Modifications to the wavelength balancing. Please, Adam, if you could try again with another subject.
I hope it works this time. I really don't enjoy shooting down these guys.
Let's try this again, hoping for more productive results this time.
I sure hope so too.
Haste. You better. We already have incoming.
boy. This time, supercharged. I've made adjustments to the infrasound delivery strength.
Sounds unsafe to me. Wouldn't that eventually risk instability?
No. Well, a little. But the benefits outweigh the risks.
Well, let's see about that.
Subject for the test. Hey, I'm the one who's in immediate danger here. You've exhausted your missiles. Fortunately, I have brought plenty. Please, take it.
Thanks.
Successfully deprogrammed a Redeemer.
He's no longer hostile, that's for sure.
Hello? Can you hear me?
What? What is this? What is happening?
Remain calm. You were possessed somehow.
Possessed? What are you talking about?
Something took over your mind. You couldn't think straight. But we just fixed that, right, Prof?
Eureka!
But I... Your sound! My head! It hurts! You shall die! I will follow my destiny!
No! This can't be happening!
No. We must cease. It's simply not working yet. I will continue the work on the Exorcist back on Avonrest. Don't fret, Prof. There is hope. You're doing important work.
Well, we at least made some progress with these experimentations. We learned something.
With continued study, I feel we should be able to cure these tortured souls one day. But not today.
Look me up when you think you're closer to a more accurate prototype. I'd be happy to help.
I'm so sorry to waste your time. Please, take this. It could be of use to you in your travels.
Though, you really don't have to.
No, I insist.
Well, okay. Thanks, Prof. Say hi to Imogen for me and look out for her. She's a sweet kid.